In the video today, I'm going to explain how to configure payment terms in SAP S4HANA, which is also applicable to SAP ECC. If you would like to know the exact points I'm going to explain today, you can check the video chapters in the description below. You can also click on any link to go directly to the point you are interested in. Before we start, I can still see there is 60% of the channel audience who are not subscribers yet. So if you are not a subscriber, please take a moment to click on subscribe and also click on the bell so you are notified about the new videos. This is the least you can do to support the channel, and I would really appreciate it. Now, let's go. We start from the SAP configuration menu, SPRO, SAP Reference IMG, then go to Financial Accounting, Accounts Payable and Accounts Receivable, Business Transactions, Incoming Invoices, Maintain Terms of Payment. There are two transactions that are important here. We have maintain terms of payment and define terms of payment for installment payments. You can always click here to see the SAP documentation. Now I will start with maintain terms of payment. And here I'm going to click on anyone. So for example, let's take this one, 0003. This is a standard payment term defined by SAP. Double click here. So first you have the payment term and you have the day limit zero. You have the description. And then here we have different boxes. So we start with this one, account type. So the payment terms in SAP, they work the same way for both customers and vendors. When you define a payment term, you can choose whether this payment term is for customers only, vendors only, or both of them. So in our case, this one is defined for both customers and vendors. Then we have the baseline date calculation and the default for baseline date. If you remember from my explanation, the baseline date is the date from which SAP will start counting the payment term. And when we create an invoice, SAP will insert a value by default in this field. We can change this manually when we are creating the invoice, but SAP will insert a default value. This default value is coming from the configuration. So here we are telling SAP that the baseline date by default should be the posting date, the entry date, or the document date. The entry date is the system date when we create the invoice. Or we can also choose no default, which means that SAP will not default any value in the baseline date. The other one, the baseline date calculation, this one will use fixed values. So for example, if we want the baseline date to always start from the first of the month, then here we will have fixed day one. So this is the day in the month. And then if we leave the additional months empty, this means that the baseline date will always be one of the current month. But if we want the baseline date to be one of the coming month always, so whenever we create an invoice, the baseline date will be the next month. Then we should add one here. Let me show you how this will be reflected in the transaction so it will be easy to understand for you. Let me open the transaction to create a supplier invoice. The transaction is FB60. Here we insert the vendor and then we have the invoice date and the posting date. So let's say the invoice date will be 01/03/2021. And the posting date will be 05/03/2021. Then go to payment tab. And here we have the payment term that came by default from the vendor master data, as I explained in the last video. I will leave you a link here. So now I'm going to change this to another payment term, 0003. And now the baseline date is coming by default as 01/04/2021. This is not the document date or the posting date. Why did SAP insert this value? Because in the configuration here, we said that in the baseline date calculation, we need a fixed day, 01, and additional months, 1. So which means the baseline date will be the first of the next month. Now we are in March, so SAP inserted the baseline date as 01 of April, 01/04/2021. Now if we change this, and I'm going to remove this value completely, and then I choose that I want the baseline date to be the document date. Save. Now let's go back to our screen. And to see the configuration impact, we have to choose another payment term and then switch back so SAP will read the tables again. So now I will switch back to 0003. Now this time the baseline date is coming as 01/03/2021, which is our document date. Or the invoice date. Why? Because in the configuration, this is what we mentioned here. Now we understand how the baseline date calculation works. Let's move to the next box. So we have here the payment terms, and this is the main configuration box here. This is where we define the discount percentages and the total number of days. So if we look into this payment term, we have 3% if we pay within 14 days, 2% if we pay within 20 days, and no discount if we pay within 30 days. And if we pay after 30 days, this means that we are late in the payment. And as you can see here, this is the standard system configuration. We can only have maximum 2 discount terms. This is a very common question. Can we have more than 2 discount terms in a payment term? No, the maximum is 2. As you see here, we can only insert 2 percentages, and the last one is only for the net. We cannot insert anything here. And I think you already know how this will be reflected when we are creating the invoice. So for example, if I change this discount percentage to 20%, then save and go back to our invoice payment. So now this is the value before we change the configuration. We have 3% if we pay within 14 days. If I change the payment term and change it back to 0003, and now we have 20% discount if we pay within 14 days. As you see, it is a very simple, straightforward configuration. Let me go back to the configuration screen. Now to this field, under the explanations, we have one called hide entry in input help. This is a very useful field. It will not impact the system functionality, but when we have a lot of standard SAP payment terms created that we don't want to remove, and then the users try to create an invoice and they try to use the entry help or the input help. And if you don't know what is the input help, then this is the one. If you press F4 or if you click here, this is what we call the input help. Now, if you see here, we have a lot of entries which can be confusing to the users when they are trying to select one. So what we can do is, for the standard SAP payment terms that we don't want to use, that we don't want the users to use in the invoices, we can select this checkbox. This means that when the user check the input help, they will not find the standard SAP payment terms. And this is it for the basic configuration of the payment terms. There are other more advanced functions like the fixed days, additional months, day limit, installment payments that I will leave up to you to explore. You can go to any field and press on F1 or right click and then click on help, and this will show the documentation for the field that is very easy to understand. Also, I will be creating another member exclusive video explaining these fields in detail. So if you are interested in checking the member videos and also in supporting the channel, I will leave you a link to join the channel membership program in the description of the video. If you like this video, then share it with others, subscribe to the channel, and leave me your questions in the comments. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.